A picture is worth a thousand words, and images play an integral part of every website. The HTTP archive has it pegged at nearly 1.2 megabytes per page, which means images take up 65% of every website. In order to do responsive web design, we need to consider images. If the rest of my page is changing based on device characteristics, wouldn't it make sense that my images should be changing too?
You're absolutely right, Cam. Using the same image, but changing the resolution is probably one of the most common use cases. Think providing a standard image for a laptop, but a 2x image for a high DPI display like a Chromebook Pixel or a Retina iMac. The best way to do this is using the source set attribute on an image tag. With source set, the browser will choose which file it wants and then only download that one.
Now that might work for logos and similar things. But what about the case where I want a different crop of an image? It doesn't make sense to show a big, wide image on a narrow portrait phone.
Exactly, and that's what's called art direction, and where the new picture element comes in. The picture element uses media queries to select which image to use. But responsive images could be a course of their own. Thankfully, my good friend and fellow developer advocate, Sam Dutton, has you covered here. Hey, Sam.
Thanks, Pete. Great stuff. When you're finished with this course, if you'd like to find out more about responsive images, stuff like the picture element, source set, come and check out our course on responsive images.
Thanks, Sam.
So, Pete, it seems like we've covered all the usual elements for responsive design. What about tables?
That's a great question. Let's take a look.